Okay, so you saw me open my Happy Meal from Catherine a few hours ago. Well, a few hours ago for me. This will probably be on a different day for you. Especially as I've learnt how to schedule my videos. Woo! But yeah, she sent me a lot of these papers. And what I've done is I've folded them in half and torn them into halves, and then I've tea stained them and folded them into signatures. I have four signatures of three, and I'm not going to bother cutting the edges so they're all even. This is going to be a vintagey style journal, so I like the rough edges and everything, so I don't want to ruin that. Yeah, and I'm going to use this wallpaper as a cover on the outside. So I just want to, before I start doing anything, I want to get the right size for the cover. So let's work on it this way. Just make sure this is clean. Because I've been playing. Ooh. Might be a little bit dirty, yeah. A bit there, but that's on the inside, that's fine. So, I'm going to want it to sort of go over a little bit, so I'm going to have room for the pages. Let's find a pencil. There's a pencil. Our baseline, and then so the pages are going to be about there. Bit of room for the spine. And then I'm just going to make this quite a simple journal. I'm probably going to use a pamphlet stitch. Okay, so that's the edge of the pages. But we want to leave the same gap that we did on this side, so. It's going to be easier in inches with this ruler because it's not got the millimeters on. Four and a quarter, yeah. Not used to doing everything in inches. Here we go. Just thinking, actually, if I cut it at 5 inches, that gives us room because there's going to be another cover around the pages. This is going to be the outside cover, so that gives us a bit of wiggle room for later on. There we go. Make sure we put that in the pink. Straight if I can. And then we can trim that down if we need to later on. Yeah, so next I want to decorate my pages a little bit. For that, I'm going to use some stamps. That one. Going to use some stays on. Nope, not black. Brown. Just in case somebody wants to add water and things to the pages. I don't know. Done. And now I need something to sew the signatures to. Not sure if I'm going to go for a piece of fabric or another piece of cardstock or paper. I don't think I have any fabric that's vintagey. So just wondering whether to use another piece of the wallpaper. Because I need it quite sturdy to sew into. Yes, I think I'll use the wallpaper. So I'll be right back. So I have my two bits cut out for front and inside covers. And I just need to mark these up. Let me think. Voila. Half an inch, and then what's in between 2 3/4. So I just do it sort of there. No, it's not in the middle. I'm no good with inches. That's more central. Okay. And then make sure they're all together. Pop your holes in. One's not really in the right place. There we go. And what measurement was that in centimetres? So 1.4. Okay. So pierce it. Okay. Right. Now it says signatures in upside down. Mm. This needs to be this way around. Crease that so I know where my spine is. Four signatures, so I'm doing four lines equal width apart, about half a centimetre. Just draw that, that's the first crease. That's one, two, three, four, and then just mark out where the holes are. Here's a little hole. Okay. Now we need some thread. I'm going to come up through the middle, first signature, up through the middle, leave some tail on the outside, down. Up the bottom one. go. Down through the middle. And then tie, well, pop that underneath there so it's on the other side of this long stitch to the tail. I've got this bit too long really. And then tie it up. I need that hanging because it's still going to be covered. Now the second one. I'll do one more on camera and then I'll go away and do the rest. So we go up through the middle. Down. Nope. Oh, dear me. Pull it all the way through. Up on the bottom one. Whoop. Whoop. And then down through the middle. This side with this thread, tie it in a knot. Don't pull it too tight because you'll snap your threads and have to do it all over again. Doesn't need to be really tight, just tight enough so your pages don't wobble about all over the place. There we go, easy. I shall do the next two and then come back. Okay, so they're all sewn in now. And I decided that I probably need a little bit of stability, so I've cut some pieces of card that will fit. I'm going to use my gel medium. And see how terrible my cutting is. Bye. sequin. I don't know where that came from. It's from when I was doing the mermaid thing the other day. And the noisy crew are back. Okay, so leave a little bit of space there for the spine to fold. And then stick the back on. Gloopy bit there. Yes. This is going to add a bit extra strength to the book. We're going to leave that to dry before we stick it to the rest of the book. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a little bit of gel medium and just add some to there. Glue the binding in place and give that a bit of extra strength as well. Wow, that wind is strong. Okay, so I should be back shortly when all that's dry. Okay, bye. Okay. We can quickly finish this up now. Just added a bit of ribbon to the inside piece of paper here so that that could dry, and now we can just stick it all together. So I'm going to add some gel medium to the inside covers. Not sure if I want to glue the spine. No, I'm not going to glue the spine. Okay. Just seeing which side I wanted for the front. I do want it to stick in the corner there, so I need some clips. Stick that back in a second. Pull this off and get it a bit closer to the spine there. move it out a bit more. Better. Nice. Right, now I'm gonna have to trim a little bit. Make it all nice and neat. Okay, I don't cut my ribbon off. Maybe decoupage is just getting here. It's getting a bit dark. I've not plugged my lamp in. Oops. Sorry if it's a little bit dark then. Okay. And that is my book. Here we go. Let me plug my lamp in and I will do a nice little flip through. Get rid of some of this stuff as well. Out of the way. Yeah. Okay, so that's all done, nice. Yeah, I don't know whether to do a little bit more to the cover or to leave it, but that's the basic book done. I hope you enjoyed that and I will see you soon.